Hey, today is a big day for Bitcoin because our lovely friend, Jim Cramer. Hold on, hey, Jimmy, what did you do with all of your Bitcoin today? Yeah, he is getting out. And should you be getting out? And you guys are like, bravo, we're going to the moon. We should call you we're going to change your name. No more Bravo. That is a terrible cartoon character. We're going with Elmer Fudd. Fear, uncertainty, and doubt. And I say no, my friend. I say T-A, man. We like T-A. And what if, as you all say, we're going to the moon, we just end up going to the backside of the moon? That would not be in the direction. I don't know where to point. Point over here, Bravo. The moon's over here. It's not on the other side. Everything on my screen is completely backwards and upside down. It's kind of like, gentlemen, you know, you get that ear hair and you're like, you borrow your wife's, you know, I don't know, clippers. Hey, you got those shears, baby? Because I got more hair on here than on top of my head, like Mr. Cramer. But anyways, ADHD, right? You're just like, how do I get that thing? And here is the story that I am bringing you. Cramer says he sold almost all of his Bitcoin, fearing China has had it with crypto. And let me forward to the clip so you can hear it out of the horse's mouth that Cramer is totally out of Bitcoin. And oh my gosh, as I'm forwarding, Doge, you're down 21%? Woo!
I know that Kate Rooney did a piece about Tether last week and how it could possibly be the weak link.
Man, are these, like, where have you guys been? Do I not do stories on this? Like, a long time ago? Man, I've been screaming about Tether for years.
So I got the Tether weak link. I got what the heck is going on that this thing's going down if it can't be mined. And I've got the possibility that
it can be mined.
Isn't the only ransomware. I'm saying that this is not going up because of structural reasons. And I know Tom DeMarc feels that this is a great technician. Says 30,000 intraday. Look out. Got a hold. Maybe the buy point.
I'm not
going there. Sold almost all my Bitcoin. Don't need it.
Well, Mr. Cramer of Mad Money, we don't. Wait, what are we doing now? Okay. We don't need you. We're okay. We'll be okay. Also, Neil just texted me. He's a friend of mine. If you want a good channel, Neil has a very good channel. Go subscribe. Neil McCoy Ward for the plug. 300,000 subscribers. You the man. He actually said to me, anything new in the videos? What do we got? Oh, shocking. There was some good stuff. I think that video probably got taken down a few times. He does great resets. Really good guy. He said, he goes, hey, Bravo, you're scaring my audience. Can you please stop? And I would love to, but first, TA. Sorry, Bravo Fudd. We need to do some TA. Do you possibly see? Do you see this? That, to me, is a lower low. Uh-oh. SpaghettiOs. Do you guys see? You know, see this little pattern here? Oh, that's a low. Oh, we broke below the lower low. And I'm going to rewind all of my videos for you all in this 15 seconds. Remember when this broke down and I'm like, oh, yikesers, right? Lower. This isn't looking good. And then we form, right, that wedge going there. Like this wedge is not going to be a good wedgie. And then here, right here, what now? What a great little flag we seem to be forming on the downside. Now, I'm sure a lot of people will say that is not the perfect TA flag. And I'd say I'd agree with you. I am literally drawing this with a crayon. But now let's get into the deep dive of this TA. Looking at this. Look at these structures all broken. Hey, kids, you better hold that this right here. And let me just move it over there for you. Also, if we want to change this guy. What kind of structure, right? Do you see what I see? And also, people give me some hate on the death crosses. It's just part of TA. It's just, you throw that in there. You're like, let's look at the this thing up here. See the two colors that's crossed? And it also does not mean right away, oh, it's, the market's going to fall. No, it gives you kind of a big picture. And maybe the kids that try to sell you on the Bybit link will talk about the golden cross here, right? Now, does it go up right away? No, it actually, it had a pullback. Ugh. But big picture, that's what I'm saying. So chalk one up for the death cross, golden cross. And then if you were to look at this one, I think this is too wonky. When the things get too close, it's like, oh, what are we doing? We're kind of going, you want some, like, look at this. All right, right, okay, perfect. Death cross, market sells off. This one sold off before. It was confused. This one, look, we had a run, golden cross, and we run. So I just want to say there needs to be a clear trend, not woo, right? Like some breakdancing 80s kid. 80s? Yeah, it was 80s. There was our next. What was that? That's a death cross. Ooh. Now, does it right away, what happens? Well, actually, it kind of did. It's like, oh, I can do it. And then we have a lower high, right? Highest high. Right? Oh, can't get it. And we just, nope, can't, nope, nope, can't. And then, ta-ding, golden cross. And then we're going to go all the way back. Where are we going? 2017. Still no golden cross. See, if something were to happen, that's a close. Oh, that was, oh, we're running out of time. Okay, right there. November 2015 is your golden cross. And I'd say, you know, coming in at a golden cross from $200, running this thing all the way up to a death cross of 10,000, I'd say dem are some gains. Also, I pinky stinky promise that this course on this, that I teach you how to do this, that's $1,000. Today, pinky stinky is the last day that you're going to see that. Tomorrow, watch, tomorrow's Monday, I don't even know what day is it. Here, let me draw it for you. Right now, it's this, 297. Because you guys were bugging me for months. When are you going to do a sale? I'm like, okay, one day. Then I've remembered, like, one day if you miss a video, you're like, what happened to it? All right, so today, 297. Tomorrow, it goes back up. So on Tuesday, kaput. Also, today is Prime Day, my wife's favorite day of the year, where I make money and then she spends all the money. When you purchase the course, I'm going to leave you guys a little secret. You can take a look. It's just when you purchase today, you'll see it, and then you can make a decision if you want both of my courses. And also, just to let you know, if you ever want to be part of these Prime Day deals, you got to put it in. I talk about it in the course. So you got to get it early. It takes months to get like, ooh, here, you get to be claimed. You get to be part of the elite that actually own businesses. Because in life, that's what you want to do. And if you wanted to know how much this guy's making a month, he's making 70 grand a month, 60 grand a month per chair. And then in the course, I teach you how to go to Alibaba, you know, other places. You can source it in the United States of America. That is fine. Have they found Jack yet? Good old China. Good old U.S. of China, and you buy it here for $30, $40, and then you sell it for $100. And actually, a little inflation, deflation, prices, gaining market share. Hey, guys, we had an advantage for about 1 year, but guess who's coming back to fight? Yes, China is. They will be lowering the prices. See, in America, we're like, yeah, we're America. We have to pay our employees $20 an hour. Doesn't really happen for the rest of the world. And over the last 12 months, or maybe longer, causing inflation is, it's been us. We have not been able to get stuff from over there. But now that over there, oh, it is piling on all in to Target and Walmart. And you're like, I would never shop anywhere, right? I'm not going to support that. We need to have jobs here. Okay, well, make sure you never shop at anywhere. And yes, I do think that we are going to have a higher print on inflation for a while until we go right back to what we've been doing for decades, which is deflation. I mean, unless you think that debt is inflationary and a GDP of 130% is inflationary, well, then we might have a bone to pick. But like always, I could be wrong. Look, hey, look, I'm wrong. I'm on the moon now. We made it. Bitcoin, crypto, we made it to the moon. We are good. But let me just explain. When you have a GDP of 130%, like we're debt, like it locks up a system. It doesn't grow. We are going into what I call another recession. Yay, this is great. Why? Because the politicians aren't going to fix this. People aren't going to go, hey, let's save. Let's be fiscally responsible. Let's have hard money. Nope. We're just going to go, everyone gets everything. 130%. It is not good. The whole system's kaput. We're not going out with a bang. We're going out with a whimper. We need a thing called austerity, and we ain't getting it. It's not happening. We are just in this perpetual, just like China. I mean, they've been doing this for decades, and we are just copying them. And I could be totally wrong. Maybe this economy is going to be booming. We're going to have, you know, the Fed's going to come out and just raise rates, and everything's going to change, and people are just going to start manufacturing, and it's going to be amazing. Yeah, I don't think that. And in my video yesterday, I'm like, I'm saying that this was the top. It's giving you a neutral. That was weird yesterday. Yesterday was a sell. Now it's a neutral. Soon it will be a buy. And looking at the chart, this is the Dow Jones Industrial Average. Can you see what I see? Or am I the only one? So there is your top. We did not come above the top. We are now trending downwards. And I think I did say we're going to have these bounces. Like, that's, markets don't, can you guys see this? Markets just don't go straight up. They don't. I mean, unless it's Dogecoin. Then it goes straight up. But other than that, and then so many YouTubers like, buy the dip. It's, okay, which is fine. It depends on where are we at, you know? Where are we at in this channel? Where are we at this this ascending wedge? We fell out of it. We fell out of the 50. I mean, sure, if we get back up there, I don't think it. Oh, I even drew a little trend line right there. Look at that. I'm like, this is what I think. We're going to get up there. We're going to bounce on that. And institution, you got pre-market, everyone was like, we're out. And then you guys, the people are like, buy the dip. At some point, you're going to look like the dip. But we could come back in, you know, like break market structure. We're back. We're riding it to the moon. Okay. But when I trade based on probabilities and I swing trade. And on this one, I have also a Bravo's daily watch list that every single day I am trading and I post what I do. If you want to take a look at that, I also have that. But do not do that unless you know how to trade first. That's where I slap your hand. I'm like, what are you doing? Well, I just wanted to see what you're doing. I'm going to copy what you do. But do you know when to get out? I mean, on the, what is this? On the daily, right up there. See the 9? That's a good swing, right? You're not a candle close above the 9-day moving average, unless you're trading on a different time frame. So if you're trading on this one, this is a clear, that, see that candle? You're out. That's it. You're done. This one here was another one. Why didn't you get out? Okay, because I'm going to wait for the bounce. Okay, congratulations. You got your bounce on the daily. But if you're trading on something like on the 1 hour, do you see? It's got same thing. After pre, you guys come in, you get the swing, you buy it, you ride it. Ugh, probably close there. Yeah, not financial advice. You'll lose all your money. Let me come back. My arrow's kind of wonky here, right? We get the sell-off. We got one candle close. There it is. And you're riding it. But guys, this is going to be a tough one. I'm just saying. So as a swing trader, you are above the 200. Fine. Okay. Just understand market structure on the swing, right? If we can get above the 50, we kind of really need that. And also, just to let you know, I do have a lot in my, not a lot, of crypto. I've just been a crypto guy forever. I love it. It's just very, very, very difficult to swing trade. How do you swing? What was today? 10%? 10% swing. What? How do you swing trade that? You definitely ain't going fishing. You're holding that screen like 24/7 because Bitcoin doesn't sleep. Something like the Dow, like these indices. Look at this swing. So clear. Up and one candle close. Ride. Close. Up. Another swing. Up. Put in a buy. Ride it. Right. It's just That is the swing.
And let me show you what it's like trying to trade Bitcoin. Here's your red day. Here's your green day. Here's your red day. Here's your green day, right? You're like, where's said diaper? Where's diaper? Oh, wait. Wait, it's up. It's up today. Oh, wait, it's down. It's where's bucket? Where's bucket and diaper? And here's Bitcoin on the second, just if you wanted to know. Okay, we're clearly going down. Here, now we're clearly going up. Hold on. No. We're clearly going down. Wait, hold on. Looks like we just launched. Like, I don't even see it. Where'd you go? Hold on. Here we go. We're clearly going up. Look at this. It's just, woo, rocket ship. Like, put in as fast as you can click the sell. Oh, you should have sold. And that is why I am jealous of Steven Van Meter, the Bond King. Because it's so, like, look, here. Oh, by the way, that's a death cross. And I was telling him, I'm not trading this under that. No, sorry, Steven. But guess what's approaching? And people are like, oh, it has no validity, right? Nah. I think I see, you know, right? They're like, after it forms, it goes up. Oh, that was like, oh, look at your death cross. It went up. Yeah, long term, take a look. And then guess what's approaching? But also on bonds, it's just like so slow. But you know, you get it. You know, one candle close. And then you ride it. And you get a whole percent. What are we up? Oh, that's not bad. That's 4%. Okay. All right. You got me on that one. I mean, yes, it did take about a week and a half to get that little amount where Bitcoin does it in like 45 minutes. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. Down 10% since open. And that's actually a lie because there is no open. It was opened back in what? 2007? Is that when it opened? It will never have a close. Well, unless we lose all electricity and the earth explodes and no one has a Tesla backup power generator floating around in space. And you want to know who's going to be owning that backup power generator that's connected to the house, like floating around in space? Michael Saylor, because he is. MicroStrategy is selling corporate bonds. I want that. Start a corporation. That's what you start a corporation and you just sell your bonds to buy Bitcoin. Sounds like a good idea. And then when everything goes wrong, you just end the corporation. Yeah. Software firm said Monday it's issuing senior. Actually, I want to look at, usually in this article, they will show you what price MicroStrategy, because I think one-fourth of their, or like what they are is only Bitcoin. You know, in your company, not to say that your company does not produce something. Do not shoot the messenger. But watch, let's see if we can see. So Bitcoin's down at about, 9-10% today. MicroStrategy is borrowing $400 million to buy more Bitcoin. Okay, why don't you just wait until the winter? Just, Mr. Saylor, just chill, relax in this article. But there we go. Mr. Down. Ah! Hey! Look it. I got lucky. 10.36% today. Huh, shocker. And Mr. Laser Eyes, we got, here it is, junk bonds. MicroStrategy Bitcoin junk bonds gets a lift from stock sale plan. I don't think the stock got a lift. I think 10% is a beatdown. And coming in from we are currently not on Earth, this man who has no body. Tens of thousands signed petition to stop Jeff Bezos from returning to Earth. Sorry, kid, you got to stay there. And also, just because I get heat, because I sell on Amazon, my course shows you how to sell off of Amazon. Yes, I've done very well selling off of Amazon. And actually, this is the site that I use. I use Shopify. No, I don't do drop shipping. I actually create a good physical product. Mine. It's mine. It's no one else's. I'm not dropshipping someone else's product. And yes, so that's what I do. And they are out of Canada. So for those of you that are like, oh, it's a Canadian. No matter what I do, you guys just are like, oh, it was founded by a guy's name that I cannot even pronounce his last name. And I'm very uncomfortable how Tobias always wears hats and leather jackets because leather is... that is not vegan, and I am vegan. Or it's just the fact that everyone comes up with every single excuse not to start a business. I don't want to start a business. Oh, during a depression, during a recession, during this, during that.
I'm going to wait till the bottom. I'm going to buy at the very bottom. Said person who had said bottom in March of last year, not the March we just came out of. I'm like, swing trade this. Look, no, it's all bad. The Fed, it's like, I'm not going to do anything. I'm just going to go punch a time clock and listen to my boss. So please, 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 if you want, today is the last day. Pinky stinky promise on that. And when you sign up, I'll give you a little like, oh, hey, I'll give you an option for the Amazon if you choose. But if you just want to work, cool. I like jobs. I'm okay with jobs. Been a teacher my whole life. I'm still teaching. That's just what I do. That's what I enjoy doing. But thank you for making it to the very tippy end, the tippy top. And I will see you tomorrow. And I'll also see you on the moon.